Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today I am going to teach how to make the phone book registration system using Java and MySQL. Let I show the demo first. Yeah, let's run the system. You will be able to see name and phone number. Here I am going to enter the name of the contact, right? James is the person. His mobile number I am going to enter. Here I am going to enter 343434. I just entered the testing 343434, right? Three times I enter, click save button, right? Now here, after save the things, here if you enter another phone number, right? So I am going to enter another phone number as Raja. You can see here, you will be able to check. Here now I am going to enter as 32. Sorry, what is the number the last time you have entered? We check here, the number is entered here, James, 3434, right? Here again you have to enter the same number 34 34 34. It will be checking. If you click save, mobile already added, right? This mobile number already added. If you enter mobile number already, you can't able to enter, right? It will be first check whether the mobile number is existing in the database or not. If it is not existing in the database, it will be added. Otherwise it throw the error. If it is existing in the database, it will be throw the error as mobile number exists. Already added. Okay, already added. Right? This is thing we have to check. Now if you added 32 32 32, click save. This number also already there, will be check. It's already there, right? It's Peter's number, right? If you added 31 31 31, click save button, mobile number added, right? Here it's a simple system we'll be did in our program, right? So let me see how to do the system, right? So first I have created the project in NetBeans, right? How to create the project in NetBeans? I already I have many videos, so I already I don't waste my time to design this form and explain. It's so boring for you all to doing again by again. I already did this one. If you are not watch my how to design this form and everything, you just go through my the video description. There are many tutorials available. You will be able to see, right? So here I will check how to add the contact information, right? Now first what I did here is I have added the MySQL connector in order to connect MySQL and Java. So here this is the database I have created, phone book. This is the name of the database, right? Inside the database I have created a table called contact. Contact as these are the column consist of contact table, ID, name and phone, right? These are the column consist of the data table contact. If you go to the structure, the contact, the ID should be always auto increment. You will be able to see the ID, it will be auto increment. ID should be auto increment. So name, this is the phone number, right? This is the things we have to do, right? It's primary. So let me moving to the code. Now this is a save button. So first what I did here, I just go to source code after design it. Here first what I did here is if it is NetBeans, when you existing the when you run the program, you are not able to get this screen. By this nice user interface, you can't get it. How to get this user interface is here, you just go to source, you have to type Control F on your keyboard. There will be find text box there. You have to type UI, press enter key. Here you have to change it as metal, right? If you are changing as metal, this type, the user interface change it as like this. This is the original Java interface. This is the professional look of Java, feel and look and feel of user interface. This is the look and feel of the user interface of Java. You will be able to get it the things if you are change it as metal, right? Right. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to create the function which is a private function. This is the private mean. This one I am going to use it only here. We have to change this if mobile exists. This mobile exists. Okay, so this same thing, paste it over here. Because this is doing by the mobile, okay, mobile thing, so we have to change the it's a mobile number. Mobile number, right. Right, okay, this is the thing. Okay, now here I created the function private boolean. Boolean is it is tested true or false, right? If it is true, it will be the mobile number already added into the database, it is true, right? So if it is false, means the mobile number is not added already. If it is a new number, it will be false and it will be allowed to add the new number, right? So here we have created the private access specifier. It's a boolean type. Boolean is it's a true or false, right? You have to understand the function. It's a true or false, right? I have created the function which is a if mobile exists, right? I have passed one argument mobile number, right? The mobile number I have to, here I'm going to put it as string type, right? So here the data type, you will be able to put it as integer. So I'm not going to do any calculation part anymore. So that I have put it here as string, okay? So first what I did here is, I have created the variable mobile. This is a text box which name is mobile. TXT mobile. I have gave the name as TXT mobile. How to give the name? Right click, change variable. Here you can give the name, right? I already gave TXT mobile, right? So what I did here is, first I have changed the name as TXT mobile. Whatever mobile number you ask, type on this text field, it is assigned to this variable mobile, right? After that, I'm going to register the MySQL driver, right? I already import the MySQL driver over here. So how to import the MySQL driver into the libraries? I already taught this stuff. Okay, if you are not watched this one, you just go through my video description. There will be the many video tutorials available. I have explained step by step there. You will be able to learn, right? So I'm not going to waste the time. If you want to, I just give the brief of the brief how to download this one. You just go to the Google search bar. Type MySQL connector for Java. It will be bring you to the different website for download MySQL connector for Java. You just download this jar file and import it to the libraries, right? How to import the library? Set the library file, library folder, right click, add jar folder here. This is the two files. You just hold on the shift key down and select and open it. It will be open here, right? Okay, this is the thing we have done. You will be check it here whether it is successfully went or not inside the library file, library folder. You can check like this, right? This is how you have to get it. After that, this is the path of this is how you have to register the MySQL driver, right? So here we have a connection path, localhost phone number, root is a username, password is blank. This is a user credential of MySQL registration, phone book as a database name, statement class, you have to create the object st, connection create statement, right? So we have to create the connection statement class, create the object st, result set object, I have created rs st dot, we have to write the execute query, we have to write the simple query over here, right? Select id from contact, right? We have to write here the select all contact. What is the query we have written here? All the tables values we have selected here. Where phone number equal this mobile number. What is the mobile number you have selected over here? It will be put into this mobile variable. You have to assign it here. So it will be check. Okay. What is the mobile number? So here we have check if RS next connection dot close RS return true mean. If there are any mobile number exist, it will be return true. Okay, it will be returning true. It will be show the error as here we have to call the function, right? It will show error as mobile number already added, otherwise it will return false and it will be allowed to add the number, right? Here we have to check, right? Select all from what is the number you entered on this particular variable. It will check with the database. You have to the mobile number here. What is the column? It will double check on this. If the number is available, but you entered here, it will be throw the error, right? Okay, that's the stuff you have to do. So this is a function we have created. If mobile exists, what is the number you entered here? It will be goes to the one parameter. It will be check. It will be done. Do the checking part over here. If the number is exist, it will be throw the error, mobile number already exists, right? If it is not exist, it is course below, and we will be added the number into the database. So we have write the prepare statement. We have created already, we have created the connection object con prepare statement object PST. So prepare statement con prepare statement, we have write the insert query over here. Insert into which table you are going to insert the record, contact table. These are the columns, phone number and name and phone number. The ID should be auto increment, you no need to enter it, it automatically increment when you add the records. So we are passing two arguments, prepare statement question mark. So what is the here, we have to assign this right text box name. What is the text box name? What is the name of the person you are typing on here? Assign this variable, mobile number assign here. So it will be getting over here, getting here. So it will be passing to here and add the records, right? So here, if you are int x equal PST execute mean, record is added. So if you are call if k equal 1, phone number is added, all the text fields are clear. Text name is request, right? It request focus mean, it will be focused on the here. When the record is added, all the text field will be clear and name should be focus, the cursor will be focused over here. That's how it's working. Very simple. I hope you guys understood things well. If you have any doubt on this, you can ask me anytime. If you like my channel, if you love my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.